My name is Lisa Lyon, L-Y-O-N. Thank you for the opportunity to speak before you tonight. My son Theo attends fifth grade at a Portland public school. We are a fortunate family. A private psychologist identified my son with dyslexia in second grade and recommended he receive private tutoring 3 times a week. So that is what we have done. Unfortunately, many students with the same learning profile as my son are not getting the recommended evidence-based instruction that they need to learn to read. I am here on behalf of Decoding Dyslexia Oregon. We are a group of parents and educators concerned by the lack of evidence-based instruction for children with dyslexia and related language-based learning differences. We are advocating for improved teacher training and delivery of evidence-based instruction. Decoding Dyslexia Oregon is part of a national movement, one of 46 chapters throughout the U.S. Parents and educators have rapidly bonded over social media, and our stories are more similar than different. We are keenly aware of progress being made in other states, and we are inspired by changes happening across the country, new laws, pilot programs, comprehensive teacher training, and successful classroom instruction. To meet Oregon's goal of having all children reading at grade level by the end of third grade, we believe it is essential to provide appropriate teacher training and explicit instruction for the 15% to 20% of students with this neurological brain difference. We challenge PPS and the state to offer meaningful in-services and to improve standards for incoming teachers. The good news is there are plenty of programs that provide results for struggling readers. They are explicit, direct instruction, multisensory, and systematic. The even better news is these programs also work for English language learners. The bad news is Oregon's teachers, through no fault of their own, are ill-prepared to instruct children with this learning difference. Currently, you cannot take a course in dyslexia in the state of Oregon. Even teachers who have their master's degrees in reading or in special education are not educated about dyslexia. Ask any teacher you know what he or she knows about dyslexia, and their response will be informative. Oregon's teachers need more tools in their toolbox. Despite the failures of the past, I am hopeful as I come before you today on behalf of a grandmother who is struggling to find services for her grandson. She shared that her father never learned to read and that she fought with the school system to provide appropriate instruction for her son 20 years ago. She never dreamt the public schools would fail 3 generations of her family. There is a strong genetic component to dyslexia that I believe has prevented many illiterate parents from successfully advocating for their children. The last place to which an illiterate person wants to return is to the principal's office. I respectfully request that this is the first of many conversations we have regarding dyslexia and related language disorders. Affected PPS students deserve more than the 3 minutes I have been afforded here tonight to discuss important changes which could improve so many lives, not to mention third grade reading benchmarks and the graduation rate. October 10th is a statewide teacher in-service day. Decoding Dyslexia would like to work with PPS by inviting teachers and administrators to attend Dyslexia 101 trainings, dyslexia simulations to begin increasing awareness of this invisible and frequently misunderstood learning difference. I know that addressing these fundamental issues would be a win-win for legislators, principals, teachers, families, and students like my son. When these issues are addressed, then everyone will win. Thank you.